Hey guys, today we are going to upgrade the Cortex XSOAR to the latest version. Before this, we did one video about how to install Cortex XSOAR. If you want to check that out, I'll leave that link in the description. So let's get started. So this one we will do for the same setup, which is a multi-tenant deployment. And there is a documentation available by Cortex XSOAR themselves. But the problem is there are some commands which are not correct on that documentation, so we'll fix that along the way. And let's get started. So guys, let's open our XSOAR servers. This one is the main server, and we have our tenant also running. So first, what we have to do is escalate the privileges into root. If you don't have the root account, then you can just do sudo service demisto stop. Okay, now we will check sudo services demisto status. Okay, service is now stopped. Let's refresh and see. Okay, it's not running. So now we'll open our tenant and sudo su sud. Okay, now we have elevated. Now let's stop the service. We are stopping these services because if we start the upgrade without stopping, there might be data overwritten from the like live data, so the final product will be corrupted. So then you will again need to reindex and do stuff like that. So it's just to be safe, we just turn off the services. Okay, let's check the status now. Okay, it stopped. Now we have to get the image of the latest XSOAR version. It's the same way as we did before. And for this site, I will leave a link in the description. If you didn't watch the first video. So I already have the file, and I will use WinSCP to get the file into my servers. Okay, let's first get the image into the tenant. This is the latest one. So previously we installed 6.6. Now they have 6.9. So new session. Site 92.168.1.6. Name, exec, password. Okay, again, yes. Okay, so we will put it in the same place as before. While this gets copied, let's remove the old image from here. Host. There are some different things when we start installing than the upgrade. So for the upgrade, we will usually start from the host, and then after every host is upgraded, then only we will move on to the main server. So let's do it first here. So the command for this one is demisto server. Okay. So first we have to change the permission. Change 6 demistoserver.sh. Okay, there's a slight mistake in the command. Okay, now so by default this will install in the slash temp folder, as we don't have a temp folder here. We will use our root, but you should have little more than 10 GB to install the Cortex XSOAR. So we will have to define a new location for this one, and I will do the command demisto server. If you are installing this in the default directory, which is slash temp, you just have to do this multi-tenant this. But if you need to define some place for this one, so we have to define a target, and the command will look like this. Good. If you are installing it into root, let me store somewhere. Okay, so first I will show you what is the problem in the official documentation. So here it will say the temp folder for installation, blah 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 blah, adding the target argument to installation before any flag. Here it is wrong. So I will leave the right command in the description as well, all the commands that I use. So we will go back to tenant and we will go to the root, cd slash root. Okay, we will make a folder, install dm. Okay, it's here. So now we'll go to home. Okay. Oh, since we are root, we'll come back to this one. Can do slash cd slash home slash purple exec. Okay, less. So we will go. Okay, guys, now we will run the command to upgrade. So it goes as sudo. Actually, sudo isn't needed when you run it as root, but anyways. Double dash target. Documentation will tell you that it's single dash, but it's wrong. It should be double. Target. Should be demisto. DM. You can either create this directory or just you can do it. It will automatically create the directory if it doesn't exist. And double dash space dash multi dash tenant. This one is also wrong in the documentation. And I will leave all the command in the description, so it will be clear for you guys. Just copy and paste it. Tenant, then we will put enter. So as you can see, it is creating the directory demisto tm. It will start installing this. Okay, it will detect our existing version, so it is 6.6. So we will say upgrade, yes. No. But as a backup, I took a snapshot from the tenant machine and the main machine, just to be sure. Sometimes things go wrong, so it's better to have something to roll back into always. Even in you are doing it like testing or production environment, always there should be backup and the snapshot taken. So we will leave it be for some time and it will do its thing. Okay guys, so let's go to our main server. So main. Okay. So now we will check the service status just to be sure. Okay, it's down. Okay, then we will check the space. Okay, we only have 8.9G in the root. We will try. We will try to install. Let's see what goes. Otherwise, we will have to enlarge our disk on the root. Right. Then we will go here and go to a new session because we need the image file to install the newest version 192.168.1.186. So name, take it, drop it here. Okay, now this is here. Now we have to change the permission. Execute. Okay, good to go. Same command here as well. Sudo demistoserver target / demisto dm space Multi-Tenant. Okay. And if something goes wrong, let's say our main server is down, but if your tenant is working and the host service up, it will run the playbooks and everything that's hosted in that particular host. So nothing to worry about that because main host is just the management. So we'll say yes. Upgrade. No, because we already took the snapshot. Okay, it will take some time to install. So let's wait. Okay, so start the server because now the upgrade is done in tenant, so we don't have to worry about anything. So we will start it. Yes. Okay, now it's running. Check the service. Okay, seems to be up. Okay, good. Now let's check if everything is in order from the GUI. Okay, let's refresh this. Okay, everything seems to be working. Now let's go to our account management. Our tenant is down because we didn't start the services, demisto services. We will open our tenant. Start status, okay, it's up. refresh this. Let's do shows as offline. Let's wait for some time for all the services to be available. Meanwhile, let's go to about. Now you can see the version. It's 6.9, which is the latest version. And let's go back to account management. Host. As you can see, now this one is online. It takes a little bit more time for the account to be available. So let's give it some time. So main host, you can see here this usage is very high, 75, and here this usage is zero. Maybe it's loading still, data is not sent fully. Refresh. Okay, it seems to be running. So now we will switch to tenant 1, which is our account in the host machine. And we go to settings, then we go to about. As you can see, latest version. So guys, that's it for upgrading Cortex XSOAR. If you found this video useful, show some love. Hit the like button and subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for my next video on the Cortex XSOAR. See you guys!